I told you not to wait up for me.
9 o'clock in the evening is hardly a long vigil. Was there some reason you thought I might have gone to bed earlier?
Well, you were having a cup of cocoa when I left you. You usually drop right off to bed.
I didn't bring the cocoa.
But you always drink your cocoa.
Tonight I decided not to, so I didn't.
I see. Was there any particular reason?
For what?
Not bringing your cocoa.
Suppose I should say that there were.
I'm saying so.
Then what would you do if I did?
Say it and see.
All right then, I did.
Did what?
Did say it.
No, didn't.
Are you sure?
Quite sure.
Then I can say.
Say what?
That there was.
Well, what?
A particular reason why I did not drink my cocoa.
Oh,
my
God.
Yes, that. I was not suspicious, merely curious. And I did hear a man's voice in the flat.
That was the radio, you
laughed again.
Her rumba is ludicrous.
And the clink of glasses.
I was finished with my water.
And then you gave a whoop of glee. Morning.
darling, darling, it's you! No, darling, not my own darling, not. Then you're gone. No, 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 I'm sorry, I'll get back on your hands. But that's lovely, darling, how it's possible. Here's the pistol. Can I walk it? No, don't be so stupid, darling. There's just no way to go and get the pistol to the side. Unfortunately, I couldn't get it from the object. I shot it three times.
Years ago. She died, poor soul, nearly 5 years ago, just after Miss Simpson.
she found out Master Edgar intended to have his child by his first wife living under their roof. If you ask me...
I ask you what, Marty?
Excuse me, sir, but I believe I hear the missus coming now.
Well, if you have- themselves quite naturally called to find out why. Oh, by the way, Mrs. Hollister, Sir Charles says your husband is not a bit of a tease.
Is that one of the Charles?
Oh, yes, of course.
And even if it were, his opinion is no more than that. After all, a husband is far more likely to be a tease with wife than his family solicitor.
I hate to admit it, but that makes a lot of sense, Inspector.
Yes, I'm afraid it does, Martin. Oh, our wretched business at hand. Would you kindly point me the way to the cellar?
Certainly. It's this way.
I see your business. Tease yourself.
You can't be spitting polish every single moment, I would say.
When did you ever see that? You've never said that in your
life. That's all.
You're the
home
of ladies.
Ladies. Ah, we have a caller.
Ladies, Mr. Hollister.
Nonsense. Why do you say nonsense, Mrs. Hollister?
And you have a latchkey. There'd be no need for him to ring the bell.
I hate to admit it, but that makes a lot of sense, Inspector.
Didn't you just say that?
A cover.
And now I'll be in my bedroom with the beastly Hank. Cheer-o!
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 Susan, I only know how to begin. Your father's remarried.
What?
Well, just 2 days ago. Friday
How much is the forgetful time? Who's forgetfulness one in your family, miss?
I don't remember. Oh, but I say, Lottie, he only just met this Miss Templeton 2 weeks ago when he last wrote me. Wasn't this marriage just a bit sudden?
A bit too sudden, if you ask me, miss.
I just did ask you.
Yeah. What's this?
Oh, just a secret drawer.
Well, I had them all over the place.
And do any of you recognise this? Well, I'm off.
Well, why don't you
we all sit down and get to know one another, shall we? There's not a music so much in it.
Yes, Mrs. Hollister.
Come now, you must tell me all about yourself. I dare say I should show some concern as you're about to marry into our family.
Well, not much to tell. I'm just your run-of-the-mill handsome young American millionaire who fell head over heels one moonlit night with your charming stepdaughter, despite the fact that I know next to nothing about her, or her family, or her background, or anything. Well, but I'll just be plain hornswoggled if she didn't throw me for a loop the moment she batted those pretty little eyes my way.
Millionaire?
Sure ought to make a Yankee feel welcome. I thought you'd be cold and reserved.
Oh, one thing to say, Mr. Draper.
Please call me Barry.
Only to call me Yankee. Oh, it's like a Randall. You don't tell me your hard work on a Sunday.
Crime knows no calendar, Mrs. Hollister.
But you have me here.
Yes.
Which question?
When I said Sir Charles
you worth our while to have just a little peep inside
the murder room.
Oh, I heard of your fame. Oh, that was just one little joke, you know how funny he is.
Yes, a barrel glass.
Always used to josh about the secret room in the cellar. Said it would be the perfect place to hide a body after a murder. Because nobody knew it was there. So we came to call it the murder room.
Nice.
No.
Oh, but you said you had some news, Constable.
Oh, well, maybe nothing at all.
Even so, I should like to hear it.
What, sir, miss? It's about your father's disappearance.
Well, naturally, what else could it be about?
Well, I don't mean about his disappearance, specifically, ma'am. I mean the actual act of disappearing itself.
Oh? I'm afraid you're having me at a loss, Constable.
Well, it's like this. In order for a person to disappear, he must be in a place and then not be in a place, do you see? Now, the problem is, if he went off, how did he go off?
Does it really matter so much?
Well, possibly not, but it does give us food for thought if you follow me.
I'm not sure I do.
Well, all right then. Let's say he's dead.
He has.
Yes, ma'am. But I wish to present this as a hypothesis.
Very well.
Well then, how did he go about that? There's only the one car and you were driving that, right?
Yes.
Right. And there were no trains out of it that night. And none of the cab companies has any record of a passenger answering your husband's description. Nor is there any record of a car coming by the house here before your own did that night.
Can you be quite sure of that?
Well, that's what Molly assured me, miss. Seems she's a light sleeper and yet last many cars broke to the house a week ago.
Perhaps the car came while it was still light out. It is July, the sun doesn't set before 8 o'clock or so.
Yes, but in that case, a lot of people wouldn't have been to bed at all yet, you see.
He may have walked.
But
She saw Mr. Hollister leave it, and...
And?
Well, he did an odd thing.
He did an odd thing? How odd thing?
Well, he removed the leg of the tenant on the second floor flag from its position near the bell push.
He did what?
He removed the leg and put it into his pocket.
What an odd thing to do.
Oh, we thought so. Yes.
Constable, I was just wondering, this witness, did she happen to notice what sort of jacket he was wearing at the time?
As a matter of fact, she did, Mum, because it was so unusual.
What was unusual about it?
Well, it was a rather expensive smoking jacket. Hardly the sort of thing one wears on the trail of a fugitive cat after dark.
It hardly sounds like the sort of thing Father would do.
No, it doesn't sound like it at all to do such a thing. Which makes me suspect that either your witness is an error, or that man was not Edgar.
Oh, was Mr. Armstrong right enough? The witness is certain that she even stepped out into the thorn, and she watched him get upon his bicycle. And she could see his face quite clearly indeed as she looked beneath them. The street love.
Constable! Constable! What are you talking about?
Mrs. Hollister.
Edgar, surely you don't want to be married without any leg in your way. And even if you do, think of Edgar's feelings. He would be heartbroken.
Oh, dash it all, she's right. What can I be thinking of?
Yes, stupid of us. We'll wait until Mr. Hollister is found.
Foul play, I might have a difficult time getting one. But you see, till I do, I shouldn't be going. knows it about. And yet I really ought to know it about in order to get proof of foul play. But you see, until there is, I can't get the warrant I need to prove that there is.
How's that again?
Never mind. Oh, I say, miss, is this in nailed shut or what?
Daddy made the lid immovable, so now we can find the secret stairway by inadvertence.
Oh, but natural, what good is a secret stairway with an immovable lid?
If the lid were movable, it wouldn't be secret.
Oh, yes, quite. But what I wondered was, how did your father use it?
Oh, now I see what you're getting at. Well, whenever Daddy wanted to use the secret stairway, he simply moved the secret switch that undid the lid. It's one of those comeback prongs.
Oh, I see. And which is that secret switch, miss?
I bet you can't say that three times fast.
I beg your pardon?
It's one of Barry's jokes.
Well,
neither do I.
Well then, what do I do to operate the window secretly?
somebody there.
Did you call me? Just
nobody certain why.
The pine wakes them up.
Inspector! Would you mind if I had one of those before you finish off anything?
Oh, sorry, Mrs. Solister. Yes. Here you are. Ah, I mean that.
Don't you mean those?
Whatever. I really must apologize, but, really, it gave me a terrible turn.
Inspector Crandall.
Yes, Mr. Hollis. Mr. Draper.
Why?
I can't follow that. Why what?
Why did it give you an awful turn to see Edgar Hollister?
Well, because... Oh, I see what you mean.
I don't very well do you mean.
Well, if I were to walk into a man's house and see the man of the house standing before me, I don't think I would go with him with sudden shock. As a matter of fact, that's just what I did, and I didn't.
Ask that again.
Did come in and didn't go with his shock.
I really must apologize. I can tell you why I reacted that way, if you must know. I had already convinced myself that Edgar Hollister was dead. Murdered by person or persons I know, so quite naturally.
Yes, of course that makes plenty of sense.
I suppose it might have that effect.
Mate, what of your own fiancé? Didn't she faint too?
Mavis is right, darling. It was a shock. And I had only a suspicion that Daddy had met with foul play.
And what about Mrs. Hollister?
Moaning and pacing and screaming at her fan and then falling unconscious like a evil wet wash.
Nothing! I was thinking of some word from Susan by the telephone. I must have fallen asleep on the floor.
The telephone? Is there somebody still on the line? Hello? Robin Smithers. Who are you? Yes. What woman? She said that to you? Yes, that must have been a shock.
Say what? What woman?
No, not you, Reverend. Oh, yes, she was quite right. We decided to hold the wedding off until Susan's father was available for it.
Oh, dear, darling, he is. We saw him here just moments ago.
Miss Hollister, I hardly know how to tell you this, but you do know it may not have been your father whom you saw.
Yes, Reverend. Well, we'll let you know soon when we decide. It'd be a terrible shame to keep you waiting by the phone all night. Thank you, and give my love to the bridesmaid.
Not my father, Inspector. I certainly know my old father when I see him.
Oh, no, it could have been dangerous.
So why would anyone pretend to be Mr. Hollister?
Well, that's just what we don't know. And until we do, I'm afraid I shall have to take Susan and the detective custody.
Oh, well, we don't know that the imposter is dangerous.
Oh, we don't know that he is, but we don't even know that he's an imposter.
And even if it is a fool, why has she to fear?
Edgar was about to make an alteration in his will, remember? Even if there was Edgar, do any of us really think he has things that he's supposed to
do? Dad, you would never have a hair on my pretty little head!
Of course not!
Nonetheless, it's better to be safe than sad!
Sorry!
For what?
Sad!
What's sad? No, what is it? I'm sorry!
Oh, sorry!
And better than what?
Sad?
Oh, certainly! Anyone would rather be sorry than sad!
Safe than sad!
Safe than sorry!
What?
Shut up!
And I shall take Susan into custody.
If you must. Oh, I say, Mavis. If Daddy does come back, will you please tell him where I am?
Oh, of course, darling. But exactly where will you be?
The police station, I suppose.
Oh, no, too dangerous. That's the first place. I'm here.
Look. No, where?
No, that's the second place. I'm here.
Look.
What would the third would be?
How about the church basement?
The back room, the beauty parlor, projection.
The
dinosaur!
The dinosaur! Ah! The baby let the inspector tell it for the end tomorrow.
Thank you! I propose to take Susan to the one place she can be perfectly safe.
And where is that?
My apartment.
See here!
Properly chaperoned, of course!
Oh, good. That's a relief.
I should say so.
Then why not do so?
That's a relief. That's what I say.
That's what you said.
That's a lie.
That makes two of us.
But chaperone by who?
Why, by Mrs. Hollister, of course!
Oh, I should adore that. Where could Susan be safer than with me? I'll just go change into something more suitable for chaperoning.
And I shall bring the car around here to the front door.
Oh, I'm only Susan Shaw. I think she's happened to eat and maybe a longer time of the journey.
Well, there's no need. I'm happy to say it's not far at all.
And then you know where the inspector lives.
Yes, we've just come from there. One of our bungling amateur attempts to solve this case.
And where is it?
It's a lovely little second floor flat on Sudbury Lane.
Yes. Remarkable work they do nowadays.
Oh, yes. No one is caught if they see many more things to artificial announcements. What would be the most how exactly natural looking with that wig and moustache of Mr. Robinson?
What's that you say? Wig, moustache, what do you mean?
I mean that when you wore them, their falseness was undetectable. You just swore they were his very own hair.
But then, sir, dance you all. Why would Mr. Hollister wear a false moustache and wig?
Solely for Miss Templeton's benefit, I believe.
You mean mate?
Yes, sir. He was afraid she might be a fortune hunter.
So, with a false hairpiece is to discourage her.
Oh, no, sir. Quite the reverse.
I'm afraid I don't follow you, lady.
Lottie.
Sorry.
That's all right. Dummies!
Where were we?
Oh, you were afraid you'd follow what I said about Mrs. Hollister wearing the starch and wig to encourage an attempt, rather than the reverse.
Yes. Why should such a get up impress her favorably?
Because they made me see my older man, sir. Well, to Mr. Hollister's way of thinking, a fortune hunting woman would be drawn to a man who didn't appear to have too many years left.
Yes, I can see how that might appeal to her, but really now, if he knew that she was a fortune hunter, why would he do the very thing that would be likely to win her? Why not act his own age and severely disappoint her ambition?
It was a lie, sir. Shakespeare called them. He was quite taken by them. Even if the woman were a fortune hunter, he had the heart to let go those legs.
Let them go?
Well, he always seemed to have pulled people's legs. It always the one.
Yes, I begin to see. And you know what? I think you may have just solved the entire mystery.
Now, wait a minute! Excuse me! Two motivations to a woman's character: being in love and talking about it. And the one
Inspector, there's no time to explain now. There's an inspector right behind you. No, no, nothing. Location and time. They will be following an inspector's car. They dare not let you get away.
Well, I'm not enough to understand, Sagittarius.
Now, there's too much to tell and too little time to do it in. Now, you must trust me, my darling, and do precisely what I tell you. Ah. This time, the pistol is not loaded with blanks.
Don't do it.
But
I did do it.
Who?
about you before the house hears your real self.
Completely terrifying me.
And I never did take the pistol to ballistic.
Because you knew all along it was loaded with blanks.
Because you knew all along I might try to use it upon you.
Which you did after failing to feed me the poison caviar.
Some of which I again failed to feed Susan earlier time.
But when I knew you were investigating my flat,
he put up the measles flat.
But Barry had already had measles.
So he dashed over there regardless.
And saw there was not one single measle on his face.
So he began to suspect you was. But then he forgot why.
And now it's quite too late.
Whatever Barry suspects.
Because we are going to finish off the two of you. And get it right this time.
There now, Susan. Do you understand?
Sorry, no. Would you mind telling us again?
I shall mind it secretly.
Dearest daughter.
But there must be a way, there simply must.
Well, there's not.
But there could be.
Could it?
Could.
Such as.
Help for Robin at the last crucial moment.
You've been seeing far too many American movies.
Yes. In real life, the cavalry never shows up in time. Now be quick about it, you two.
Where are you taking us? The quarry.
Have you guns off? Some rocks at your feet? A lovely splash? And it all over.
What is that, Miss?
Susan said something about a
upon the table.
Why?
Well, because it looks so sloppy on the floor.
No! Don't let him do it!
Why not?
It may be a trick!
Oh, Inspector, whose side are you on, anyhow?
Oh, dash it all like a flea. Not! Mavis, darling, I was wrong. It's not a trick. Let me go ahead.
Daddy, I'm so disappointed in you.
Oh, disappointed in me, dear, as though I never fall. Now Susan did it ever occur to you that perhaps I am going to trick her?
Daddy, that would be too much. Wait! I don't intend to put up with any trickery. Leave that lad alone.
Very well. Go ahead and shoot. I don't care. It's a shame, though.
What is?
That once you shoot me, you'll never find the secret safe with all the emeralds in it.
Secret?
Say, emeralds? There's no such thing. You're bluffing.
Of course not. Go ahead and shoot.
Darling, I'm glad.
Everyone's melting.